So today we are going to start the bearing of a line. Of a line, as it is already told in the class, bearing of a line, it is defined. It is as the horizontal angle which a line makes with some reference direction, known as meridian. For example, I will take the reference. And this is my in this reference line. Okay, so I named it as a north line. Again, bearing of a line is the horizontal angle which a line makes with some reference direction known as meridian. So we have two types of meridian. So here I can say this is the line. This may be line AB. So this is meridian. This is the angle theta which a line AB makes with some reference line. So I will tell you what is meridian. We have two types of meridian which are used in our practice. Number one is true meridian. True meridian. So what is true meridian now? True meridian of a place, is a direction indicated by an imaginary circle, passing around the earth through that place and to geographical poles. For example, our north and south poles. This is actually true meridian. What second type of this? We have the magnetic meridian. So when I will not go in details. So when you are freely suspend the magnetic needle, that direction indicated by that needle is known as magnetic meridian. When a freely suspended magnetic needle is indicated by that direction is known as magnetic meridian. So we have two types of meridian. So here I have told we are going to measure the bearing of a line. Okay, so this reference axis may be north. We can say this is north, and this north may be true north or magnetic north. If we are going to measure with the help of prismatic compass, so this north is known as magnetic north. Okay, any angle, any line that makes the horizontal with it is the bearing of the line. I can say it is AB. So theta is the bearing of the line. So next we are going to discuss what are the different types of bearings. So designation of bearings. First is whole circle bearing. Simply we can say WCB. Then we have the quadrantal bearing. Or we can say it is or reduced bearing. So, this is recorded by QB or RB. So what is the difference between this? So we will give in detail what is whole circle bearing. So what is whole circle bearing? Again, bearing is the inclination of any line with the north. If bearing is the again horizontal angle with the reference, so this is my, I can say this is north. It may be true north or it may be magnetic north. So this angle with this north, this is my line AB. This is the bearing of the line. This is my AB. I can say theta. When the value of this theta lies between 0 degree to 360 degree, it is known as whole circle bearing. Again, I will give the examples. Suppose this is your north. This bearing may be 60 degree. Then next is this the north. This bearing may be like this 120 degree. And then this is the north. This bearing may be this is 227 degree. Or if again this is the north, this bearing may be 310 degree. So this is my line. We can say this line is AB, this is CD, this is PQ, or this is ST. So these are different. So these are the bearing, these are the horizontal angles that any line makes with the north. Is when its value lies between 0 to 360 degree, this is known as whole circle bearing. Then we are going to start the quadrantal bearing, QB. Quadrantal bearing or reduced bearing. Again, it is the horizontal angle. What we have the four quadrants like this. Always mark at the top is north. Your right hand side as east. I think it is automatically south and west. Okay. So this is my first quadrant. This first quadrant is known as north east quadrant. This is my second quadrant. But in math, it is the second quadrant. Not we will go clockwise, not anti-clockwise. Zero is on the north. You will start as clockwise direction like this. Okay, this is my first quadrant, this is second quadrant. This quadrant is known as southeast quadrant. Southeast quadrant. Now this is my third quadrant, this is known as southwest, not west south. And this is my fourth quadrant, it is known as northwest quadrant. So when you are going to discuss about this, first quadrant is northeast and second is southeast, third one is southwest, and fourth is known as northwest. Why it is so? Because when you are going to measure the angle with respect to any line. Our major basic line is north south. Okay, so if the value lies in the first case, it is 60 degree angle. Okay, now this angle is 60 degree. This is whole circle bearing. Whole circle bearing lies between 0 to 90 degree. So we can add one thing more. When we had discussed about this thing, first quadrant, second quadrant, third and fourth quadrant, whole circle value. So here we have taken the value as this is my angle theta. Then I have taken 120 degree, 220, 70 degree, and this is 310 degree. So again, I will take this 60 degree when angle is so 60 degree. 60 degree means this value lies between 0 to 90 degree. So how we can represent this? In this, so you can say this is 60 degree because the now value of theta, this is theta, okay, this value of theta is lies between 0 to degree to 90 degree. If the value lies between 0 to 90 degree, it is in the form of reduced bearing or quadrantal bearing, it is known as north 60 degree east, okay. Then second, in this case, the second angle we have taken as 120 degree. When the whole circle bearing is 120 degree, I have taken from here, this is my 120 degree. Okay, this angle is 120 degree. For this now, we will take the nearest pole. Nearest pole is north, it is south, not north, it is south. This is the angle. We will represent it as alpha. Here theta and alpha is same. You can see this. Theta. So for this case now, this is angle alpha. So how much is this angle alpha? This we can calculate 180 degrees, this much angle. Deduct this 120 degree. So you can write over here, in this case, the value lies 90 to 180 degree. This lie 120 lies between 90 and 120 degree. So far in this case, it is south. How much is this alpha? Alpha east. Here we want to know what is alpha. Alpha, we can say alpha is equal to 180 degree minus. Here alpha is equal to 180 degree means this angle total is 180 degree minus this angle remaining is alpha. Minus 120 degree, so this come to be 60 degree. The answer for this is equal south 60 degree east. Okay, in the third case, when it lies between the 227, it in the third quadrant. So when this angle is 227 degree, this is the angle, this angle is 227 degree with the north. So it lies in the third quadrant. Third quadrant is named as southwest. Third quadrant. So its value lies between 180 degree to 270 degree. Again, here is 0, here is 90, here is 180 degree, and this is 270 degree, or you can say here 360 degree. Okay. So for this, we are going to calculate the remaining thing. So when the value 200, now this value is 227 degree lies between 180 degree and this. So this is in the third quadrant. So very close to this is alpha. This line very close axis is south. So this is our angle alpha. So we can say in here, in this case, it will be south alpha west. We want to calculate how much is alpha. Alpha is how much? How much is this angle? This total angle is 220 degree. Alpha is equal to 227 degree minus 180 degree. This comes to be 47 degree. So far in this case, we can say south 47 degree west. And the last one is when the value of this 310 degree, it lies in the fourth quadrant. So you can start from here. This value is, I can say, from north is 0, this is 310 degree. Okay. 310 degree lies over here. This value is 310 degree for this case now. So this lies in the northwest quadrant. So very close to this line is this angle. This is angle alpha now. So it lies in the fourth quadrant. Fourth quadrant is known as northwest. Here its quadrantal value will be north alpha west. What we have to calculate, how much is alpha? This alpha is equal to total angle is 360 degree minus 310 degree. This come to be 50 degree. So we can say the quadrantal bearing for this is north 50 degree west. So these are the next bearing designation, quadrantal bearing and whole circle bearing. Like this we can convert the whole circle bearing into quadrantal bearing, quadrantal bearing into this. So in the next video I will again give you some conversion factors.